breath, swinging it from right to left. Baseline, all of my people moving around. Feeling the heat up in the street, rocking the beat, rocking the beat, rocking the beat. Beating the drum, feeling the funk, blazing the skunk. Beating the drum, feeling the funk. Swinging it from right to left, right to left, right to left.
To the beat.
Hold the breath, swinging it from right to left. Baseline. Feeling the heat up in the street, rocking the beat, rocking the beat, rocking the beat.
To the beat.
Baseline. All of my people moving around.
We gotta work together, it's been too long.
Hold the breath, swinging it from right to left. Baseline. All of my people moving around. I'm hanging you up, the new beat, rocking you up. I'm fucking you up, my black hole, knocking you up. Feeling the heat up in the street, rocking the beat. Step up in the club, take me to my reserve seat. Baseline. All of my people moving around.
Is this DJ bringing the funk for y'all? That's what I thought. Come on.
But here's the good news.
Yeah. Drop the beats out. Now, if you people want to get busy, I mean, if you really want to get busy, I'm talking about getting down busy. I'm talking about bringing the funk and getting down. Then we're gonna do it like this.
Hold the breath, swinging it from right to left. Baseline, all of my people moving around. Feeling the heat up in the street, rocking the beat. Picking the drum, feeling the funk, blazing the skunk. Picking the drum, feeling the funk.
Here's the good news.
I'm going to be bundling a few steps together that are requiring epoxy, so that I can just knock out a bunch of stuff at once. And here's what's about to happen. I am about to glue on these triangle guys. They're called doubler plates, and they go right up under here. It's just kind of some extra support. These are the areas where the bolts go through the bulkheads to bolt the halves together. So I'm gluing in four of those. One there, one there, one on the other side, and one on the other side. I am also going to fair out this little area here. Kind of see the gap right here that I'm talking about. So just kind of cleaning up these areas like that to make them look a little bit better. And then lastly, I am going to be installing this, which is, this is the mast step. And that is what the mast is going to be sitting on. So I got to glue this thing down here before I put on the foredeck. And then the foredeck has a little hole right here that the mast goes through. And then we'll sit on this mast step. All right, so I'm about to do all of that. The best way to tell when this stuff is ready to apply, you know, some people say to make it the consistency of, like, you know, peanut butter or something like that. I feel like the best thing to do is to actually taste it. I'm kidding, this is actually yogurt. And just don't get it on your shirt.
Do you think that's good?
Let me see.
Can it dribble a little?
Yeah. Try to just put it on the top. Like, you turn the brush sideways like this.
Okay.
and then line it up at the top. Okay. Okay. All right. Nice job. All right. High five.
Oh yeah.
Here, thumbs up to the camera. Got another little tip for you for anybody who hasn't worked with epoxy before, and that is to wear some clothes that you do not mind getting epoxy on. Pretty simple, but also very very important. I've got epoxy on various places on my clothing. Let's see, there's just there. I've actually got it all the way across this here shoe. There are quite a few shirts now that have epoxy on them, and you don't mean to get epoxy on stuff, but you just realize at some point that parts of your clothing are no longer flexible. Just another little tip for what it's worth. Alright, so this big old piece here is what's called the bow locker section. This piece goes up there on the bow. And actually, right, let's see, you can just kind of perhaps see a faint circle there. That is the place where the hole for the mast will go. It'll be drilled right through that this kind of backing plate right there. And this big gaping hole is where this will go. I bought a nice hatch, so that'll end up going right there. We'll have a lot of kind of a nice dry storage area inside this bow locker section, so that'll be really nice. And what I need to do next is I need to kind of thicken these edges up a little bit with these strips of pine. And that'll give the mounting screws for this hatch a little more wood to bite into. Then I'll epoxy those down into place. So just like that. Now I've got a long piece in the back, two long pieces on either side, and one piece right here in the middle. I'm gonna let these pieces run long like this. Just to kind of give this area some more support. It just seems like a big, wide, flat area, and it's only this quarter-inch plywood, so seems like it could use the extra support. So, yeah, I think it's a good idea. This is the dagger board trunk. The dagger board's gonna slide down in here. So now that I know how to put it together, I just got to get it all epoxied together now. So here is the daggerboard trunk assembled. This is actually looking at it upside down. This is the part that will this will be in contact with the bottom of the boat, and the daggerboard slides in from the underside here. But that is it. A little bit tricky to put together with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parts that are all epoxied at once, but we got it done. All right. Nice. Some people call me the space cowboy. Yeah. Some call me the gangster love.